Hi everyone and welcome back to the channel. This is a problem from the British Maths Olympiad in 2006. There are two methods here that I want to go through with you, but if you want to give this problem a go, pause the video now and when you're ready, we'll go through the solution. For the first method, we can note the significance of x squared plus y squared. So we can realise that this is very similar to cos squared plus sine squared equals 1. So thus we can use polar coordinates for x and y. So we can say x equals r cos theta and y equals r sine theta, where r is just some real number. And thus, substituting this into our equation, x squared plus y squared becomes r squared cos squared plus r squared sine squared, which is just r squared. And the right side becomes r squared times cos theta sine theta multiplied by r squared times cos squared theta minus sine squared theta. So dividing both sides by r squared and then using the double angle formula for sine, so we can note that sine of 2 theta is equal to 2 sine theta cos theta, and cos 2 theta is equal to cos squared theta minus sine squared theta. So now this expression reads as 1 equal to r squared times 1/2 sine 2 theta times cos 2 theta. And once more we can apply the double angle formula on sine 2 theta cos 2 theta. So this is the same thing as writing it as 1/2 sine 4 theta. So thus we have that r squared is equal to 4 over sine 4 theta. But since we know that sine 4 theta is less than or equal to 1 for all values of theta, then it follows that the minimum of r squared must occur when the denominator is 1, or in other words, r squared is 4. And we already noted earlier that r squared was the same as x squared plus y squared, and so thus the minimum value of x squared plus y squared is 4. For the second method, we can use a more traditional algebraic approach. So to do this, we're going to try and write the equation in terms of x squared plus y squared and xy. So if we go ahead and square both sides of this equation, then we arrive at the following. And we can rewrite the right side as x squared y squared times x squared plus y squared all squared minus 4x squared y squared. And if we let a equal to x squared y squared and b equal to x squared plus y squared, then we arrive at b squared equaling a times b squared minus 4a. And by expanding this equation and then factorizing it, we can show that b squared is equal to 4a squared over a minus 1. And so from here, it follows that a must be greater than 1 and b, which is the sum of two squares, must be bigger than 0. And so to find the minimum of b squared, it suffices to find the minimum of a squared over a minus 1. And we can do that using the substitution u is equal to a minus 1, so that a squared is equal to u plus 1 squared. And putting it back into the expression, we find u squared plus 2u plus 1 all over u, which we can rewrite as u plus 1 over u plus 2. And once more, finding the minimum of this expression is the same thing as finding the minimum of u plus 1 over u. So we can note that u is greater than 0, so thus we can use the arithmetic mean, geometric mean inequality. So that is to say that 1/2 of u plus 1 over u is greater than or equal to the square root of u times 1 over u, which is just equal to 1. And thus the minimum value of u plus 1 over u is at 2, which means the minimum value of this expression is at 4, and thus the minimum value of this expression is at 16, which implies that b, which was x squared plus y squared, has a minimum value of 4.